My name is Engineer Adebeson, the coordinator in charge of website design. This morning, we shall be putting you through how to design a website. And one of our facilitators that will be putting you through this today is the person of Engineer Adelakun. So, I'm imploring you to make sure that you take note of everything that will be taught today. Because at the end of today's lecture, you will have gained a lot. I can assure you that you will be able to design the website on your own. Thank you very much. Welcome to website design class. So I will start with the introduction to website design. In 1990, Tim Berners-Lee developed skeletal outline of the internet, which include the web browser and web server. And when we talk about web server, these are special computers that store web content and are always connected to the internet. And we have been talking about website design. So website design is the process of transforming an idea or a story into a visually appealing design. A website designer models the layout of the websites. So, the terms website design and web development are often used interchangeably. They are notably different. And when we talk about the word web development, it's the process of transforming the design into a live website. Web development uses web languages and software tools in the development of the design into a functional website. Example of what we are saying is this. When we talk about a web developer, can be compared to a builder who takes the architect design and transforms it into a real structure. Now, when we talk about the website design and development process, the first stage there is what we call the discovery. It is all about information gathering. When we talk about information gathering, what that means is that we collect data that what is the website all about, the website we plan to build, what are the things the company do, what and what is just all about information gathering. And the second stage, which is the plan, the planning, that is the developer creates data that gives a customer an opportunity to judge how the entire site will look like. But under the site map, we have two different key stages. The first stage is what we call the site map. It shows the relationship between different pages of a website. And we also have another notable part, which is what we call the wireframe. It only describes the elements that will be added to the location. And when we talk about the design, that is the third stage. All the visual contents, such as images, photos, and videos, are created at these steps. And that one also is what classified into two stages. The first one is what we call the mock-up. Mock-up fill in the visual details that wireframe neglects, adding skin to the bones. They can be created using programs such as Photoshop, Adobe Illustrator, Sketch, Fireworks, and so on and so forth. And what we are trying to say here is that the mock-up will look as if it's a real website, but it's just like an image. And when we talk about a prototype, prototypes are like mock-up, enriched with interactions, animations, and anything else you would like to experience when clicking button. They can be created using programs such as Dreamweaver, Figma, Adobe XD, and so on and so forth. But when we talk about the mock-up, what we are trying to say here is this. It's just like a demo, which is what we will also show to you. This is an example when we talk about a site map. What site map means is this, just a sketch that, okay, what and what, or how does everything interact? Example of what we mean by that is this. Like, for example, when we check most websites, the first place we will see, that is what we call the home page. And from the home page, we can go to services, technologies, contact us, and so on and so forth. And from this figure shown here, for example, look at About Us. From About Us, we have work processing building, testimonials, blog, jobs, and so on and so forth. And another example here is when we talk about the mock-up. Look at the mock-up. That is just a sketch. It's like a paperwork. That will give us an idea that, okay, with this mock-up, this is the header. From the header, we just have, okay, this is the name of the site, the logo, and some text. We are just going to do a kind of sketch. So that is what the mock-up explains about that site. And the next is what we call the content writing. It's so important. This involves the creation of catchy headlines, text editing, writing new text, compiling the existing text, and so on and so forth. And that is where we write all what we need. Like what we say, the heading. The heading must be catchy. The heading is what must show that, okay, this is what must brought people to decide that, okay, this is so good. And when we talk about the text editing, it must be error-free. And the next stage is what we call development/coding. In the development step, the website design is translated to actual code that makes the website work. And at the beginning of this lecture, I talk about some web languages. Example of web languages is HTML, which is an acronym, and which we also talk about later. But when we talk about HTML, we are talking about hypertext markup language. That's the full meaning of the acronyms. And another thing we have here is CSS. And the CSS, that is what the full meaning of the acronyms is, cascading style sheets. And we also have the JavaScript. And when we talk about JavaScript, that is what automates some parts there. Like for example, maybe you have a website and around the area of the footer where you have the copyright, you want to automate it to change automatically at the end of every year, or you want to put a current time on the website, on the web pages, you are going to use a JavaScript. And you also have PHP, which also make our form to work easily. And we also have the XML, which is the extensible markup language. And we also have the jQuery, Ajax, and so on and so forth. And the next stage here is what we call the testing and launching. When we talk about the testing and launching, testing of the site is critical, as there will be inevitably issues that need to be addressed before the site goes live. What we are trying to say here is this: whenever you have a website, after you are through with it, before the website is launched, it must be tested by more than one or two individuals that will look for any error. So that what we are trying to say here is that to look at it, if there is any broken link. So that is what we are sure there, and make sure that everything is put in order. And the last but not the least here is what we call the maintenance. It includes things like updating content, making changes to the code, and fixing broken links. That is just to mention a few. And when we talk about maintenance, it's so essential. These days, we see maybe an advert of 4 years on some websites, which is not too good. So that is why we must maintain our website from time to time and check if there is any changes. So that is what that is all about. Now, that leads us to what we call fundamental principles of design. And under fundamental principle of design, the first stage here is what we call color and contrast. When we talk about color and contrast, color of a website should not just complement each other, but also contrast each other enough to make this easily visible. We have two figures here. Look at the first figure, enter to win, and the picture and the color here, this is a kind of what we call a color riot. The color don't complement each other. But look at the second figure here, the color blend. So that is what we mean there. When we talk about the color and contrast, the color must blend. So that is it about color and contrast. And the next is what we call the white space. White space, another name for the white space is what we call the negative space. It is the space around various elements of a design. The elements of a design need to have enough white space around them so as to make the design usable. From the first figure, that shows that that don't have enough white space. The text is so close to the edges, while the other one is set, the text is well centralized. So that is it when we talk about the white space or negative space. The next, which is also another important key, is what we call the visual hierarchy. It is the order of importance of elements in the design. When we talk about the visual hierarchy, the first feature, for example, that's just write everything using the same kind of test, no degree of importance. Why the second figure? The figure B shows like enter to win. It's a key thing that people must know that there is something that I must do here, I must enter to win. Why at the end of the day, that those anybody that click that site must enter their email address. But after that, there is another key important thing there, which is what enter today, which is important. Visual hierarchy will make sure that all the important elements are put in place so that anyone viewing the website can note that easily. And the next is what we call complexity and simplicity. Designs are better when they are simple rather than complex. Like for example, look at the figure below here. Enter to win. Like inside here we have your email address, which is somehow embossed. And the embossing have changed the outlook of it that your email address is not that too visible. So when designing a website, it is mandatory that the text, but everything there must be simple in a way that it will be visible. So that is what that means. And the next here is what we call consistency. When we talk about the consistency, similar elements of a design should appear consistently throughout your design. What that means is this: whenever we are building a website, it is mandatory that if, for example, the menu bar, we use a particular text size or font, that must be maintained all through. And the color also, we must maintain it. There should be nothing like maybe color riot, or we use 14, or we use Time New Roman here, and we later change it to Georgia. We must be consistent when we are building a website. And the next year, that is what we call a scale. And when we talk about a scale shows us how big or small an element of design is. So which also, this gives us an example of that. When we talk, for example, we say enter to win. And when we say enter to win, look at this now. The first figure there shows everything, just as if everything is just small. Like for example, where you have to enter your email address, that text is too small. So when any key or any visual hierarchy, any point of notice should be more visible. That is why on the second figure here, you have it more visible, your email address, which is what someone must see very well, and enter today. So that is it about that. Welcome once again to the part 2 of this website design class. And now we want to talk about the basic HTML tag. When we talk about HTML tag, that is the fundamental something when we talk about website design. Irrespective of the editor we use, we make use of HTML tag, either directly or indirectly. And under HTML tag, the first thing we have here is what we call HTML tag here. This is the first tag in your HTML document. This tag tells your browser that this is the start of an HTML document. The last tag in your document is this, that is less than sign with forward slash HTML and the closing tag, which we will still talk about later. This tag tells your browser that this is the end of the HTML document. Note, every tag open in HTML must have a corresponding closing tag. So you open like this by writing the less than sign, and you are going to put the document there, and you are also going to close that the same way. That is for the opening tag, with the information you want the tag to perform inside. But when you want to close, you make use of forward slash. So as shown here, that is the way you have it there. And next here, you have what we call the head. This tag represents the document header, which gives other HTML tags like title, link, and so on and so forth. And when we talk about the title, it means like the title of the page. Maybe we say, welcome to my first web design page. And the link, maybe like meta tag and so on and so forth. Title. This tag is used inside the head tag to mention the document title. And body. This is an essential tag. This tag represents the document body, which keeps other HTML tags like H1, division, and P. Like this H1, this is an heading, which we are still going to talk about. And this div, that is for division. And this P, that is what we call paragraph tag. Now to this H1 tag. This tag represents the headings. And when we are talking about headings, we have 6 different kinds of headings, starting from H1, H2, H3, H4, H5 to H6. With H1, which is the highest tag, and H6, that is the lowest tag or the smallest tag. And we have P, that is the paragraph tag. This tag represents the paragraph body, breaking paragraph into sections. Now, the markup language is predefined with set of tag and is a building block for web pages that is displayed in a web browser. So this set of tags are written on Notepad, Notepad++, Sublime Text, brackets, and so on and so forth, and save it with an extension .html or .html and use the browser to display it. Note, there are some web editor that irrespective, immediately you start working, it is assumed or it knows already that you are working on a web environment, and it will just save it .html, except you want to save it in another format like .php or .css. An HTML file is a text file containing small markup tags. The markup tags tell the web browser how to display the page. The first page of a website is commonly named index.html. That is the common name for it. And images for web can be in these common formats: the JPG or JPEG, we have the PNG, and we have the GIF. And the PNG, that one is editable, while the JPEG, that is just an image file, which is not editable, and the GIF, that is the GIF, that is somehow editable. And when we talk about, by default, a transparent background of a JPEG or JPG is always white. Now to the basic structure of the website. That is the fundamental HTML block. This is how the tag look like in the real sense. When we talk about the HTML tag, that is the first tag here. HTML, and I've said something earlier that whenever you open a tag, you must close it. And the first tag in HTML, that is HTML tag, has opened here, and it's also closed at the end. Why we have the end? And I've also explained earlier that the title tag or the link tag is embedded in the head tag. An example here, the title of this document or web page is Wale. And we have the body tag. And from what you saw on the screen, there is a kind of space in between. The space in between here shows or indicates that is where all the content that will be displayed on the website will be. Anything written inside this body tag, that is what will be displayed. So that is it about that. And this is a sample web page. For example, look at what we have here. When we write the HTML tag, the edge, the title here now, which is changed to my first web page. That will just show where you have the URL. And the URL means Universal Resource Locator. And we have the head tag. We have closed the head tag here. And we have the body. Next, you have a P tag here. This P tag shows that this is what we call the paragraph tag. This is my first web page. This class is, look at this B tag now. This B, that is the tag for bold. Whenever you ask, okay, what is the tag for bold? That means you are going to use B tag, and you will close it by using the forward slash. And you have the paragraph tag. This is the closing tag for the paragraph, and you also have the close tag for the body. Because whenever you open a tag, you must close it. Except only on few cases that some special tag don't have the closing tag. And at the end of the day, the HTML must be closed. Now we have what we call the web browser. Though I've talked about it briefly at the beginning of this class, it is an application software that render or display the hypertext tags in a readable format. It provides the needed interaction on the World Wide Web. That is what we call the WWW. Example of common web browser are Opera Mini, Google Chrome, Flux, Crazy Browser. We have the Mozilla Firefox, Netscape Navigator, Internet Explorer, Mastery Cloud Browser. We have the UC Web, and so on and so forth. Next, now we have the web development tools. When we talk about web development tools, we have several web development tools, but few are listed here. Example of that is what we call the Dreamweaver. When we talk about the Dreamweaver here, this Dreamweaver is a web editor, and it also has the functionality of drag and drop features, which can be easily editable. If you are a coder, you can work in code view, and if you are what a designer, you can work in design view. And if you want to work in both view, you can also put it in split view while you work. And when we are talking about the number of sites that can be created with maybe a Dreamweaver or any web package, it is unlimited. It's not only one or four or five. And we also have what we call a paid web page maker. It's also a web development tool that can be used. And we also have what we call the NetBeans, which this is also essential for the coders or programmers that love coding. And it can also work for other packages, like maybe Java and so on and so forth. And we also have what we call the Microsoft Visual Studio. That is also a web development tool. It's so essential. It's also from Microsoft. And we also have Adobe Flash. Adobe Flash, that is for animation. Maybe when you want to animate a particular place or point, you can use Adobe Flash. Or you want to put a particular web page in a scene, or to do a kind of GIF or anyhow, maybe a video content, you can do it very well with Adobe Flash. And we also have Notepad++. Notepad++ is a good web development tool that can debug and correct your error. And we also have what we call the Switch Mask. Switch Mask is also good for animation. It's good and it's easy to use. You can just look at a particular image, you can turn the image the way you like, and you also have Adobe SD. That is also good for prototyping, like the way Dreamweaver is also good for prototyping. And we also have Figma. Figma is also good for prototyping also. You can prototype. When I talk about the word prototype, what that means is that it makes your website look as if it's free. There are some interaction. When you click a button, it will go straight to the expected point or the expected web page. And now, the last but not the least here, that is what we call the Sublime Text. When we talk about the Sublime Text, it's also a web editor. You can use it to code. And the next here is what we call the list. When we talk about lists, HTML provides a simple way to show another list. And when we talk about another list, that is bullet list. And we also have other list, that is numbered list. And now to another list. And another list is a list of items marked with bullets, typically small black circle. It has no special order or sequence. That is why the name is on order. And we also have another list starts with the UL tag. When we talk about the UL, from that word we see the U. The U there is on, why the L means on, that is the UL means on order. Each list item starts with the LI. That LI is from list. That after you are putting UL, you will still now put list tag, which I will still show you, and that will also be closed. And what I've said earlier, this is an example of that now. Look at it, at the beginning of this now, we have this UL tag, which is for another list. And what I have on this list is some of the schools we have in the school at Federal Polytechnic Ilaro. We have engineering, we have the School of Applied Science Management, we have communication and information technology, environmental, and you can see at the end of the day, at the end of every list, it is mandatory to close the list, and after everything, you are going to close your another list. And you also have type attributes. What type attribute means is this, that what of in a case that those don't want to put it in a small circle or something like that, you can put it to be in square shape. You have this disk and you also have a circle. Now to what we call the other list. An other list is also a list of items. These list items are marked with numbers. An other list starts with the OL. The OL is for other list tag. Each list item starts with the LI tag. You can see now the only difference here is that at the beginning of another list we have UL. While at the beginning of this we have OL to differentiate that this is other list. And it's going to what? Write number 1, engineering, 2, applied science, 3, school of management, and so on and so forth. And this class will not be complete without mentioning some acronyms. Some of the major acronyms or the common acronyms, the first one here is what we call hypertext markup language. We stand for the HTML. And the next is what we call the CSS, cascading style sheet. That is the second one. It gives some functionality to your web page to move it from static. So, and we also have what we call the HTTP. That is hypertext transfer protocol. And we also have HTTPS. Because these days we discover that, and it's all, they always glamour or say this everywhere on the net, that whenever you want to transact, maybe you want to do some online transaction, it is advisable to check that the websites have this HTTPS instead of the HTTP. The S here is just the difference, which shows that is what the site is secure, that you can't be duped. And next here is what we call the www, which is what we call the World Wide Web. And next here is what we call W3C, which is the World Wide Web Consortium. That is the body that governs what's happening around the website. And next here is what we call WYSIWYG, which is what you see is what you get. It's also a web editing software that immediately you click it, it has a drag and drop features. That once you click, maybe color, instead of writing the code, once you use what you see is what you get, it will display it for you there, and it will also generate the code. And you also have what we call the DNS, which stands for the domain name server. And next here is what we call the URL. Uniform resource locator, and it is mandatory every website must have a unique URL. Like for example, the unique URL for Federal Polytechnic is www.federalpolytechnic.edu.ng. As that one has been assigned to FPI, it cannot be assigned to anyone again except the domain expire and you fail to renew your domain. And the next here is what we call the SML, Extensible Markup Language, which is also used for the websites. And for more this I've said now, I've thrown more light into it. And let me also add this, whenever you are working on the text editor and you discover that there is an asterisk sign at the upper or at the edge, close to where you have the title of what you are working on, that shows that you have an unsaved document or work. Thank you very much for listening. For me, you can go ahead.
Sir, What is the meaning of HTML?
That is hypertext markup language.
How many levels of heading does HTML have?
That is 6 headings.
What element is used to create a paragraph, sir?
That is P elements.
What is the meaning of HTTPS?
Hypertext markup language. Hypertext transfer protocol secure.
Sir, what is DNS?
Domain name server.
Sir, can you please tell me the full meaning of WYSIWYG?
That is what you see is what you get.
Sir, what is the meaning of URL?
That is Uniform Resource Locator.
Sir, what does CSS stand for?
That is Cascading Style Sheets.
Sir, what is the full form of www?
That is World Wide Web.
Sir, which of the headings provide the largest text?
That is H6.
That is all we have.
Okay, thank you very much for your question. It's a pleasure meeting you. Thank you.